Hey there, I'm Kirk and this video covers the important topic, Earth Overshoot Day. Have you ever thought about what would happen if your yearly budget, that needs to last you an entire year, is all spent by April? Just picture that scenario. Tough, isn't it? Now, let's take that concept and apply it on a grander scale, our planet Earth. This is the essence of Earth Overshoot Day. Earth Overshoot Day marks the date when humanity has used up all the resources that our planet can regenerate within a year. It's like an ecological credit card, and we're spending well beyond our means. The alarming part is that this day arrives earlier each year, indicating our consumption habits have intensified. Rewind to the 1970s, Earth Overshoot Day fell in December, almost at the end of the year. Fast forward to last year, and it was already in July. That's a significant shift. Almost half a year earlier. It's like spending your entire annual budget in just over half the time. This trend reveals a sobering truth. Our current consumption patterns are unsustainable. We're literally borrowing from our future to satisfy our present needs, and the debt is piling up. If we continue down this path, we're not just looking at an overdraft on our ecological account, but a complete bankruptcy of resources. What's at stake here isn't merely our comfort or convenience. It's about the very survival of our species and countless others. It's about the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the soil that grows our food. It's about biodiversity, climate stability, and the delicate balance of ecosystems that have evolved over millions of years. What we're facing isn't a plot from a dystopian novel. It's a potential reality if global consumption continues unchecked. In the grand narrative of Earth, every choice we make, every resource we use brings us one step closer to the next. Earth Overshoot Day. And the question is, just how close are we willing to get before we change our course? Remember, this isn't a plot from a dystopian novel. It's a potential reality if global consumption continues unchecked. So, what happens when we overshoot? What does it mean for our planet, our wildlife, and our economy? Well, the consequences of overshooting are far-reaching and severe. Our planet is like a bank account, and we're spending more than we're depositing, leading to a serious resource deficit. This isn't just about running out of oil or natural gas. This is about the loss of fertile soil, the dwindling of clean water supplies, and the unpredictable nature of our seasons. Imagine farmers not knowing when to plant their crops, or entire regions facing severe water shortages. This is the grim reality of overshooting. And it doesn't stop there. The loss of biodiversity is another chilling consequence. We're not just talking about losing a few species here and there. We're talking about a mass extinction event, where countless species vanish every year. These species aren't just creatures we admire in nature documentaries. They play crucial roles in the ecosystems that provide us with essential resources like air, water, and food. Now, let's talk about the economy. In a world of limited resources, scarcity can trigger a sharp increase in commodity prices. Everything, from the food we eat to the clothes we wear, could become significantly more expensive. And for businesses reliant on these resources, the impact could be catastrophic. Picture this, you're a business owner and the cost of your raw materials doubles or even triples. How would that affect your operation? Could you still turn a profit, or would you have to downsize or worse, shut down? And it's not just business owners who should be concerned. Entrepreneurs, investors, even regular consumers, everyone would feel the pinch. As we continue to draw more and more from our planet's finite resources, we're not just borrowing from future generations, we're stealing. And the bill is coming due. For those of you watching who are business owners, entrepreneurs, or investors, how would doubling or tripling the cost of raw materials affect your bottom line? Now, let's make this personal. Have you ever calculated your own ecological footprint? Let's delve into the concept of an ecological footprint. It is a measure of human demand on Earth's ecosystems. It compares human demand with planet Earth's ecological capacity to regenerate. It represents the amount of biologically productive land and sea area necessary to supply the resources a human population consumes and to mitigate associated waste. Now, how do we calculate this ecological footprint? Well, there are several tools available online to help with this. One of these is the Global Footprint Network's calculator. This tool takes into account factors like your diet, transportation habits, and consumption patterns to give you an estimate of your footprint. To put it in perspective, imagine a bathtub. The water flowing out of the tap represents the resources you consume, and the drain symbolizes the Earth's ability to regenerate those resources. If the water is flowing out faster than it's draining, you're in trouble. The tub is going to overflow. That's exactly what's happening with our planet. We're consuming resources faster than the Earth can replenish them. And our ecological footprints are the measurement of that overflow. Now, you may be wondering, what can I do about it? The good news is, a lot. Even small changes in our daily lives can have a significant impact on reducing our ecological footprints. Consider your transportation habits. Could you walk or cycle instead of driving? What about your diet? Could you reduce your meat intake and opt for more plant-based meals? Your shopping habits can also make a difference. Could you buy less and choose products with less packaging? And remember, it's not just about reducing consumption, it's also about switching to more sustainable options. Could you replace your electricity source with a renewable one? Or could you compost your organic waste instead of sending it to the landfill? Remember, every action counts, and no change is too small. It might be an eye-opener to see how changes, even small ones, can reduce your impact. One powerful change, accessible to many, is altering our diets, specifically reducing or eliminating animal products. Now, you might wonder, why diet? How does what we eat have such a profound impact on our planet? Well, let's start with agriculture, particularly livestock farming. It's a major consumer of our resources. Picture this. To produce just 1 pound of beef, we require over 1,800 gallons of water. And that's just the beginning. Livestock farming also takes up an enormous amount of land, often leading to deforestation and habitat loss. Moreover, it's a significant source of methane emissions. Methane, if you recall from your high school chemistry class, is a potent greenhouse gas. In fact, it's over 25 times more potent at trapping heat in our atmosphere than carbon dioxide. This contributes to global warming, which in turn fuels climate change. But what if we were to shift towards plant-based diets? The impact could be enormous. First off, it's much more efficient. Plants require fewer resources to grow than animals do to raise. This means we could drastically cut our water and land footprints. In addition, a plant-based diet could significantly reduce our carbon footprint. How so? Well, plants absorb carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. So, the more plants we grow and consume, the more carbon dioxide we remove from the atmosphere. That's a win for us and a win for our planet. But It's not just about going vegan overnight. Even reducing our consumption of animal products can make a difference. It's about making conscious choices about what we eat and understanding the environmental impact of those choices. Ultimately, our diet is a personal decision, but it's important to remember that it's also a decision that affects our planet. By making mindful choices, we can contribute to a more sustainable world. So, next time you're at the grocery store, consider this. What you put in your shopping cart doesn't just affect your health, it also impacts the health of our planet. By shifting towards plant-based diets, we can drastically cut our water and carbon footprints. So, what can we do, starting today, to ensure a sustainable future? The first step is education. We must equip ourselves with knowledge about our planet and our impact on it. We can read books, attend lectures, or watch documentaries. The internet is a vast resource of information at our fingertips. Let's learn about renewable energy, sustainable farming, conservation efforts, and more. But education isn't just for ourselves. We should also share our knowledge with others. Discuss with your families, friends, and communities about the importance of sustainable living. Encourage schools to incorporate sustainability into their curriculums. Remember, understanding is the foundation of action. Next, we must advocate for sustainable choices. Start small in your own homes. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Compost your kitchen waste. Opt for products with less packaging. Switch off lights and unplug electronics when not in use. Choose public transportation, biking, or walking over driving when possible. Every little action counts. Then, let's look at our workplaces. Advocate for energy-efficient practices, such as using LED lights or installing solar panels. Encourage your company to implement waste management systems or to go paperless. If you're a business owner, consider sustainable options in your supply chain. But our influence doesn't stop at our homes or workplaces. We can also make a difference in our communities. Join or initiate local conservation efforts, plant trees, clean up beaches or parks. Advocate for sustainable policies in your local government. Choosing renewable energy is another significant step towards a sustainable future. Solar, wind, hydro, and other forms of renewable energy are becoming more accessible and affordable. If you can, consider installing solar panels or a wind turbine at home. If not, you can still support renewable energy by choosing energy providers who source their electricity from renewable sources. And finally, voting with our wallets can make a big difference. Support companies that prioritize sustainability. Choose products that are ethically made and environmentally friendly. I invite you all to reflect on this. What kind of world do you want to live in? And what are you willing to do to make it a reality? Let's not just imagine a sustainable future, but actively work towards it, because the future of our planet is in our hands. Thanks for watching this video. Every view helps me spread awareness and also helps my channel grow. Please like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, stay aware and stay healthy.